Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day. Welcome to today's video, which is the fifth in a series of tutorials helping users transition from the Panasonic Lumix FZ200 up to the new FZ330. In this video, I want specifically to look at shooting 4K stills. Now, the 4K stills mode allows you to capture an image within a video sequence and extract that as a JPEG image. So for example, on the table I've got Newton's cradle and I'm going to set the balls in motion and I want to capture the point where the ball is out to the right hand side with minimum string tension and again when it's out to the left hand side with minimum string tension. Now I couldn't do that without a lot of effort and precision timing if I was trying to do it with the shutter button alone. So the 4K video shoot mode allows you to capture a frame within that sequence at the exact point that you want it to be happening. With 4K shoot, you can actually set this up to give you any aspect ratio you want. So in the record setup menu, on page one, where you've got the aspect ratio, you don't have to shoot in the HD format of 16:9. If you wanted to, you could select a 1:1 or a 4:3 aspect ratio. The camera will record in that format. For this sequence, I am going to stay in the 16:9 HD format. Now we set the aspect ratio, the second thing to set is the actual mode of operation that we're going to capture the 4K photos in. If I go into the menu on page 2, there's the 4K photo menu option. If I depress that, it gives me three choices. The first one is what's called the 4K burst mode, and it will capture an image sequence as long as I hold my finger on the shutter button. It's the mode that I will most often use, as it gives me the opportunity to start and stop the sequence as I require. The second option is the press the button to start and press the button to finish. So for example, if you've got your camera set up on a tripod, you can use this to start the sequence, allow the event to take place, and when it's completed, you can press the shutter button to stop it. The final option is a special case which allows you to capture just 1 second before you press the shutter button to 1 second after. What happens in this pre-burst mode is when you press the shutter button, for 1 second before you pressed it, it has been capturing that video information for you, and then it will capture 1 second after you press the shutter button. So you get a 2 second sequence for you to capture the image point that you want. As I say, it does require some precision timing to do that, as you'll notice when I demonstrate that event. So let's start by going into the 4K burst mode of operation, which is the one I'll normally use. Once you've set that, you'll need to go into the drive mode to set up the 4K shooting. And the drive mode is selected by the bottom navigation button. So you may have been in the 2 second timer mode, but you'll need to come across to the 4K drive mode. And that shows you're in 4K photo and reminds you you're in the 4K burst mode. To get success with this method, you need to be using a very fast shutter speed. If you use the same frame rate that you would for video recording, so you're going to use a shutter speed which is twice the frame rate. So for example, here we're shooting an MP4 at 30 frames per second. Normally for smooth video, we would select a shutter speed which is twice that, so a 60th of a second. But a 60th of a second would give us motion blur, and that's not what we want when we're capturing a still image for this sequence. So if you're outside capturing birds in flight, you'd be needing to set something like a 500th of a second exposure. If I look at the exposure now of this tabletop scene, it's 1/60th of a second at f2.8 with ISO 100. It will capture me an image, but it will give me image motion blur. So I'm first of all going to increase the ISO up to 400. And you'll see that the exposure now is 1/640th of a second. So that's going to be adequate to stop this motion. So we set up the aspect ratio, we set up the shooting mode, we're now ready to capture that image sequence by just depressing the shutter button to start and stop it. So I'll walk around the front of the camera and I'll start the ball swinging and I'll bring out two balls to the left hand side and I'm going to try and capture a sequence where the two balls are out on the right hand side. So I'll just gently bring these out and try and keep them in a straight line. Release them and now come round and press the shutter button. And I'll hold the shutter button down for a couple of seconds just to capture an image sequence. Now you can see the camera has built up an event for me. I've got a slider at the bottom which allows me to scroll through the images just captured. And there's a scale on the top which tells us what point of the image sequence we're at. So you can see the yellow bar is at the beginning of the sequence. As I scroll through them, you'll see that the position of the bar at the top changes to indicate where I am in this sequence. And you notice that I can scroll through each and every individual frame. If you find that using the slider is difficult, then you can either use the F1 key, and that brings up a transport set of buttons, and you can use the four-way navigation dial to either play the video or single step through. So if I wanted to single step, then I use the left and right cursor keys. If I wanted to play forward, I'll use the up key. If I wanted to play backwards, I'll use the down key. So I can use now the navigation button to actually single step through. So I'll try and capture this sequence when the two balls have gone out to the right hand side. At that point. Now I need to capture that image by pressing the menu set. So when I press menu set, it brings up the option to save the image. And I'll say yes. If I wanted to capture it in another point in time, then again I can use the navigation buttons to bring the balls to that point. So it's just started to move out, so I'll select that point. And again, to capture the image, press menu set, save the image, yes. Let's look at the special case sequence now, where we just get that 1 second before and after the shutter button press. So I go into the menu, select the pre-burst mode and press menu set, come back to the shooting screen, and it means now that when I press the shutter button, I'll just get 1 second before and 1 second after the event. So I'll go around again to the front of the camera. I'll take out one ball this time. I'll let them swing, and I'm going to try and capture it when it's out to the right hand side. So again, it's brought up an image sequence. You don't get the option to bring up the F1 for the play mode because we've only got 1 second before, or 30 frames before, and 1 second after. And you see now the camera's brought up on screen a slider again, and on the top of the screen you'll notice the image sequence number, which is 0, which means at the instant that I press the shutter button. I can go 1 second before, which will be 30 frames. So I've got 30 frames to the left, which is 1 second before the button was pressed. And again over to the right hand side, 29 frames, which is the 1 second after the button was pressed. So I can select within that sequence the point that I want. Again, I can use the navigation buttons if I find using that bottom cursor difficult to use. So that's the point that I want from the right hand side. Again, press menu set to save the image. And that will save me the JPEG image for that particular point in the action sequence. You don't have to rely on capturing that image the moment you shot the scene. I can actually go into the replay mode. That is the one we've just done, the single step. I can go to the previous video, which is that one. And again, when I press the up key, it will build that image sequence for us again. And again, I can use the cursor keys to step through to find the point that I actually want to capture the image. So if I wanted it to capture that swinging out there, again, just press menu set and yes to save the image. So that is 4K stills shooting mode. So the points to remember are set your aspect ratio, set the mode that you want the 4K operation to work in, normally the burst mode. Set a high enough shutter speed to prevent subject motion blur, and then select the frame from the image sequence that the camera builds after you release the shutter button. That's it for this short video. Thanks very much for watching. If you are a new viewer to the channel, please do click that subscribe button or click the link in the video description below. Also check out my photographic blog, and I'll put a link to that in the description below as well. You'll find more information on this and other features of the FZ330 and indeed the FZ1000, which will also capture this same image sequence. So until my next video, thanks again for watching, please do take care, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye for now.